it's full of lovely little arrangements, little things, and recalls of big band tunes. The first one is the title of this set, and then I leave the boys alone, and Rico will go on telling you everything about any mute and everything. He's trying to do the best of. Yes. So it's Coolie Williams and his Rock Cutters from 1936, I think, 35, 36, 38, whatever. And they kick off with Rendezvous in the Rhythm. Rhythm.
Ellington, due to recording contracts, I think it was, he thought, let's have some small bands. And he
he doesn't put his name to it, so he could go with different record labels. And they also gave his main, some of his main guys a little bit more kudos by having their name put on records. Johnny Hodges had a band. What was it? Hodges is one called. Johnny Hodges' Orchestra. Okay. And there was Barney DeGard and his syncopasis, wasn't it? So each one of them had a chance. Rex Stewart led some, so that's what all this is about. And then there's magical pieces. So let's go straight on. And this next one is I can't give you anything but that. And it's Coolie Williams here. When I listen to this, he's listening to that original recording by Louis Armstrong. He heard him live actually in New York, and he went to speak to Louis Armstrong after the gig, and he says, "Mr. Armstrong, do you mind if I walk back home with you?" Because it was living in Harlem. And he says, "Yeah, sure." And Coolie said it was the most wonderful experience walking home with Pops. You know, that's great stuff. So you can hear it in this solo as well. I can't give you anything. Decided to add to this plunge of it. He added the straight mute. The straight mute is a classic mute that was invented for the trumpet in the classical era, because a lot of the, even some of the great composers, thought the trumpets were far too loud, so they had to be muted at some point. There's a great story of Mozart when he was 12. His father introduced him to the trumpet, got a trumpet player to come play, and he fainted. And I think that's what... It did, yeah. I think that's why Mozart never wrote a trumpet concerto. Haydn did, which is great, you know. And so, but anyway, so... So you've got this straight note there, which is... gives it a very individual sound as well. And then you've got the guys, you know, King Oliver and guys around there picking some bowls or cups off the table to get a different sound. I get this one from, this is an actual sink plunger, which I bought. I always buy lots of them, but they're very expensive. This one was $4.75 from my local hardware shop, and I always go in there and I'll take the trumpet and I say, can I see your plunger? And they look at you very strangely and you get this out of the case and go, that's good. Great, I'll take a couple of them, please. And then you take the stick off and leave you with that. And of course, Duke Hyten's got this lovely story. He says when he goes into his hardware shop in New Orleans, the guy says, and if you ask for a plunger, he says, you must be a trumpet player. He goes, yeah, what do you do with all the sticks we give you, though? The hardware shop guys, we give them to the drummers. So this next one's another Coolie Williams one called Jubilester.
Thank you.
sound the two together, the scraping and the plunger, which is really, Coolie Williams took it to its extent and made it his own. So straight on with the same sort of sound with the rug cutters, and this one's called Blue Reverie. Hodges on the soprano saxophone, which apparently soon after that, Hodges did the classic knocked on Duke's dressing room door and went to have a meeting with him to ask for more money because he was playing that second instrument. And he got the usual reply from Ellington, you know, about how it was actually Hodges' privilege to be with this band. So the alto saxophone soon after that went under the Hodges bed and was never seen again in a recording studio with Ellington. which is a shame really, because Hodges was a beautiful soprano player, and recreating it for you today was that wonderful sound of the soprano saxophone, Hodges sound, Lars! So we're moving on to the Rex Stewart lineup now, but this is a later one, and I think it's called Blue Seven. I'm unprepared for this, you see. I've just got it thrown, the microphone at this last one. Yes, Rex Stewart's Big Seven, I'm sorry. And it's a classic old Ellington one again, Diggy Diggy Doo, but this is probably the most modern number. I think we might even go more modern than Alistair's...
1948.
No, we are not going that far. It's beyond the pale, isn't it? This is 42 actually. And it's digga digga digga.
Thank you.
Henri at the bass player. And Felix at the guitar. Of course, Christoph Pite at the trumpet. Jean-François at the clarinet. And Christoph at the trombone. This is lovely, this next one.
And it's called
Have a Heart. No, it's not the Wizard of Oz.
Put him out.
Let's just do the junior hop to finish. Ladies and gentlemen, I sort of briefly introduced you to most of the chats, but Martin Litton on the piano.
Yeah!
And also, stepping in at the last minute, David Hornibaugh, apparently. So we'll do this switch poem to finish. It's a lovely one, it's called Junior Hop.
One, two, one, two.